Good afternoon, friends. This is time to discuss a Sunday afternoon type topic, which is that why do so many people fail at trading despite learning all kinds of strategies and all the entry techniques are easily available on YouTube, and anybody can choose one strategy a day for the next 1 year and he will not run out of strategies. So the issue is that why then more people are not successful. I think there are two human qualities without which I don't believe people can be successful at particularly trading and life in general. Number one is most people are not patient. Okay. And why is patience needed? Now, before I elaborate on that, let me tell you that we have specific modules on patience in our recorded webinar, which is available for 2000 plus GST, in our live webinar, which is on 19th of December, again 20,000 plus GST. And we have join buttons, which is silver, gold, and diamond. But what do you need to add to those join buttons is what I am going to talk about. So for any questions, WhatsApp 98710-66337 or email at ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com, which is ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. Okay, now we were talking about patience. Most people are impatient by the time they get to their 30s because being patient in life has not paid for them, which means that they told you to stand in line to drink water. And in this sort of a overpopulated country, you are probably the last one to have water and then get scolded by your teacher. Everywhere they told you, be patient, you lost. And what you saw was that people who are impatient have done better in life than you have. So that gives you a streak of fear of missing out. So even while you know that you have to wait for a specific setup or two or three types of setups, you jump in to the market as it opens because you cannot take being patient or being out of the market. So impatience works in life, but it does not work in trading. And I have personally dealt with impatience, so I really know and understand what I am talking about. Okay. Patience can be intraday, it could be multi-day, it could be waiting for a few weeks, etc. But patience is needed. You have to wait for the market to get into a corner where the risk is low and reward is high. And that will not be the case all the time. Often the market will deceive you by going higher and making you believe that you have missed out. So patience is so important. It is not an overrated quality. With time, with maturity, people do get, do learn to become patient, but the impatient trader will get hammered left, right, and center in the market. So that is one of the major issues that most people have. What I have learned in my life is to practice patience, which means if I am eager to get something, wait for that urge to die down. Now that could be an ice cream, that could be a pair of shoes, that could be a new suit. So those impulsive urges of impatience are the same. They don't differentiate whether it's a trading issue or a non-trading issue. So my advice to everybody who wants to control his patience is that each time you have a desire, what you have to do is wait for that desire to go away. A simple example was I had to quit smoking. And for that, whenever I used to get that urge, I had to remind myself that I am going to quit smoking. This urge will not make me touch a cigarette. And a similar, emotional urge happens in a trader when he's dealing with this sort of impatient trading. So patience is a virtue that can be learned, it can be practiced. Now, patient till what? So you should have a particular setup in mind that till, this happens, till the price comes back to the 20, I am not going to touch it. Till a higher low is made, I am not going to touch it. Okay. So this is one of the problems that most traders have. The second problem is discipline. Now, what is discipline? Discipline is getting out of a trade because it is not working. Accepting that despite your best efforts, despite the best analysis, sometimes things will not work. And if you see the market not acting in line with your expectation, you will cut and go home. There is no ego about it. So you have decided your exit point and you will take that exit no matter whether it happens 4 times in a row. And the discipline is that when something starts to work, I will make it large. The problem with discipline is a bit more complicated because there is a need to be right which is mixed with it. If you're the sort of person who's been right all his life, then trading is going to humble you and how? So it needs a humble person who accepts that he will be wrong some of the time. Now the problem the average retail trader taking courses and seminars, etc. has is that he thinks because he has taken an XYZ seminar, because he has bought XYZ books, the market owes it to him to give him money. But your trading experience starts the moment you put on your first trades. So forget about how many seminars, how many YouTube, how many books you have read. Trading experience is needed. And the market makes sure that you have put in the required number of experience hours before you become successful. Okay. So when I get a question that if I buy your recorded webinar, will I become successful? I don't know. because I don't know how patient you are. I don't know how disciplined you are. Okay. Once you add your experience to that recorded webinar or to those strategies, they will give you result. But because you have spent 2000 bucks, so from Monday morning, you will become successful. I don't think it works like that. And that is a very stupid expectation. So basically, if you apply both of these things together, discipline, are you a good loser? A lot of times in our childhood, we saw people who were bad losers. They would get angry, they would take their bat and wickets and run home. A good loser is who loses with grace. A bad loser is who tries to insist he is right. Again, a different form of discipline. So these are, you know, very vital issues that people must deal with before they become successful at trading. Trading is a test of your human qualities. And the best human qualities will win here. Okay. The best human quality is humility, patience, waiting for things to come to you. Those who play cricket or have good knowledge of cricket, most of the time, the timing is good if you wait on the ball. If you are too eager, then you are prodding at the ball. So, like in life, similarly in trading, timing happens when you wait for things to happen and come to you. I hope this little talk may have solved some issues. So, that would be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.